The time is 20,000 years from tomorrow. A man is addressing a great throng of people. Listen to him.
Excuse me, please. I'm laughing. I know it isn't polite, but I can't help it. The funniest thing. Wait till you hear it. Absolutely the funniest thing. Yes, I'll tell you. A hoax. He tried to play a hoax on me, telling me it was an authentic record of their times and expecting me, to believe. Now, wait a moment. I'll start from the beginning. No, really, I will. And then you'll laugh with me. I know you will. Well, it started like this. An old man comes to my study a little while ago, a package under his arm, and he tells me he's a student of the past. past master of humbug, that's what he meant. Now, wait until you hear it. So, he has this package under his arm, and he says to me breathlessly,
"How kind, sir. I brought you the most wonderful relic of the past the modern world has ever known."
"Really," I said. "What are you talking about, and who are you?"
"A lonely traveler, one who wanders in far-off places."
far-off places, that's what he told me. So I said, and is that what you're bringing me from one of those far-off places?" He shakes his old head like a strutting rooster.
"Yes, indeed. You are the greatest living scholar of the history of the old world, so it is fitting that I bring this to you."
"Indeed. And what have you got, and where did you find it?"
"I was walking through the mountains beneath which the great city once stood."
Well?
"As you know, thousands of years ago, there was another civilization that reached great height."
I know. Certainly you're not going to teach me history, my ancient friend."
"Oh, no, indeed. I only meant to say, what I found high in the mountains, it is a written record of that civilization. The first written record ever to be found."
For a moment, I couldn't breathe. I just looked at him. I said, "Have you gone out of your head with age, old man? Nothing is left of that ancient time. We believe that first the deadly radiation covered them when the dark planet swung close and then the molten rock thrust up. It's only our theory that men had a civilization here before us." For answer, he tore the paper off the package.
Look, these papers, reality, I tell you. High in the mountains, inside a piece of alabaster that must have protected it from the ravages of time, miraculously spewed out from the earth when the mountains rose up through the land. Look, sir, and read. A record of their times. A record of the ways of men 20,000 years before our civilization came into being.
Yes, he said that, and I took the book, took it in my hand and read. Now listen to this. First, the crazy book said that... Oh, wait until you hear this. First, the book said that the men of that past civilization fought about the land. You don't understand what I mean? The world, they fought each other, maimed each other, bled each other over who owned what piece of the world. Did you ever hear such nonsense? They knew how large the world was, and they knew how many men were on it, but instead of sharing it in fairness, they fought each other. Yes, bloody wars for years and years. Do you ever hear such humbug history? And that isn't all. The book said they fought each other over race. Yes, race. The book says the word means the difference between men. And then the book said that all men had the same origin, and yet they killed each other over a difference they admitted did not even exist. Oh, what a fraud that book. And a man walked that world for a little while and said, "For the glory of God, peace on earth." And he spoke truth, and men listened and said, "We believe." And then went out to murder with bright music playing. Music, I tell you. And then a little man arose who said, "For the glory of the state, war on earth." And he spoke lies, and men knew they were lies, and he knew they knew, but again they went out to murder with the music playing. And here's the climax. This preposterous book said that these crazy people who filled the earth in those days had machines with which to fly through the air. Yes, really, through the air. Imagine the wonder if it were true, speeding through the air like the birds, great glistening machines to carry men to new wonders, but guess what the fraud of a book said they did with them. Oh, you'll hold your sides when you hear this one. They loaded the machines with horrible tearing things and flew over the crowded places and dropped them. Yes, believe me, that's what this humbug history tried to make me believe was the truth. Men struggled for centuries. Men studied. They toiled. Rivers of heartache, at least the book said so, trying to make a healthier world for their children to live in. And then they threw poison clouds down from the sky and killed them off in the tens of thousands. Killed the children. Oh,